Hello everyone. In this lecture, we are going to know about how constructor works when inheritance. If we are implementing any type of inheritance and we are having a constructor within our class, so we will know about how our constructor will behave and which constructor will be called first, constructor of base class or constructor of derived class. So here we have two classes. We are actually taking the example of single inheritance. We have base class and we have child class, and the child class inherits the property of base class. So we will have two constructor in the one is in the base class and one in the child class. So I am creating a constructor. So constructor, here we have a constructor. And the name of the constructor is base, because this is the property of constructor that constructor should have same name as that of the class. And constructor does not have any return type, so I am removing void from here. Similar, I am creating a constructor of child class. So for that I will have to write class name child, and here I will write the body of constructor. So in this in the base class constructor, I am writing a message, simple message I am writing here, base constructor. So this is our base class constructor. I am writing an endl because I want to print other output on the next line. So I have written here endl. So in the child class I am also displaying some message, child constructor. Actually we cannot inherit the constructor. The constructor will be called once the object of the any class will be created. So in the main function we will create object of the base class and child class. So first we will create object of the base class and we will see the behavior of constructor. So I am writing here base class name and followed by an identifier obj. Now the obj is an object of base class, so I can use obj for accessing the member functions of base class and member data of base class. So now, once the obj object will create, the constructor will be automatically called. So the constructor will be automatically called. So we have a constructor base. It will call and it will display message base constructor. But in this program, our base class has a constructor, but the constructor is in private area. So for accessing constructor outside the class, we need to keep it in the public area. So we will use here public, and we will also use here public keyword, so we can call constructor. So now once we create object of base class, at the same time the constructor of base class will be called and we will get message base constructor. So I will run this program. So now you can see the message base constructor. Base constructor will not base class object will not call the constructor of child class, because child class is not inherited by base class. Actually, in this program the base class the child class has inherited the base class, not base class inherited the child class. So child constructor will not be called here. If I create object of derived class, the name is our in type class is child. So in this case the object of the base class, object of the child class is created, and the constructor of base class will run first, after that the constructor of child class will run. So if we have more than one parent class, in that case all the parent classes according to hierarchy will be called first, after that the child class constructor will work. So in this example we will see, we will get message as base constructor. In the next line we will get a message child constructor, because first the base class constructor will be called because we are creating the object of child class, after that the child constructor will be called. So in this console you can see the message base constructor followed by child constructor. So I hope you understood how the constructor will work in within the inheritance. So in the constructor will work according to hierarchy. First the parent class constructor will work, after that sub parent class constructor work, after that sub parent, and at the last the constructor will be called of the class for which we are going to create object. Thank you so much for watching this video.